Hello everyone, myself Stuti Parekh. In this video, we will discuss about the famous architect Frank Lloyd Wright, his design philosophy and one of his famous work, Johnson Wax Building. So let's learn about Frank Lloyd Wright. He was an American architect born on 8th June 1867 in Wisconsin in USA. He worked under Louis Sullivan. He created a philosophy of organic architecture which maintains that the building must develop around its surroundings. Organic architecture strives to integrate space into a unified whole. FLW was not concerned with architectural style because he believed that every building should grow naturally from its environment. FLW first became known for his prairie style of architecture, which incorporated low-pitched roofs, overhanging eaves, a central chimney, and open plans. Wright is best known for organic architecture, which drew from the natural resources combined with Japanese architecture. He believed that there should be as many styles of houses as there are kinds of people and as many differentiations as there are different individuals. He also believed that the good building is not one that hurts the landscape but one which makes the landscape more beautiful. Wright stood for clean lines and simplicity. His buildings generally had low proportions which were not very high, which was related to the ground. Planning was done according to the function of the space. FLW introduced the word organic into his philosophy of architecture in the early 1908. It was an extension to the teachings of his mentor Louis Sullivan, whose slogan was "Form follows function," became the mantra of modern architecture. Following are the main characteristics seen in his works. First is use of natural materials like bricks, stones and wood. Next is use of textured concrete, design that blend well with its environment. And lastly, he focused more on residential designs. Now we shall discuss the famous building of Frank Lloyd Wright, which is Johnson Wax Building. The architect is Frank Lloyd Wright. Type is corporate office and a research laboratory. Location is Racine in USA. The construction began in 1936 and ended in 1939. This building is named after the client named Hip Johnson, who wanted to create a small urban to put offices in a green area more distant from the city. The neighborhood in which this building is placed is in the outskirts of the Racine in an industrial area. As a result of the environment, this building closes itself as a fortress and is isolated from its environment, that allowed Wright to create his own idea of architecture inside the walls. Its most identifiable elements are the dendriform, which means tree-like columns. Wright's ability to effortlessly incorporate the organic metaphor into his architecture is revealed in the building via a tall, slender mushroom column which tapers to a base of 0.2 meters in diameter. They rise 10 meters and terminate at the roof level as a broad circular lily pads of concrete which are 6 meters wide. The circular lily pads, as shown in the figure, are of concrete and woven together by a membrane of Pyrex glass tubing that illuminates spaces with natural lights. The use of Pyrex glass tubing allowed for a lot of diffused light to enter the interior of the building. The large workspace is lit with indirect light and very little glare, resulting in work environment conductive for creativity. The exterior walls were constructed using red bricks. Other major materials used in the construction are red sandstone and RCC, which is reinforced concrete. The mushroom columns and glass tubing ceiling formed a large workspace nearly 1/2 acre in size. The main room, which was also known as the great room, has two circular elevators as shown in the figure and a mezzanine, which is also shown in the figure. The building has no windows, only long blind facades and impressive red brick walls. Wright designed a horizontal amount contrary to the tall buildings that were so fashionable at that time. Campus has a vertical tower as shown in the figure, but this does not belong to the original design and was constructed 10 years later. 10 years later, the company was forced to expand their offices due to the operation of business. Wright designed a tower adjacent to this building. The tower is of simple shapes. The square is extruded with round corners. The main hall of the Johnson Wax building is about 45 meter by 65 meters, and which is able to accommodate about 200 employees under one roof without any partitioning. The management areas are located on the second floor along the walkway around the main room. The third floor, that is the restricted access, houses a meeting room and a private office of Hip Johnson, the owner. When one enters the gate, the ground floor is open and is often used as parking spaces. In the main building, around 60 columns are constructed. The columns are in addition to the characteristic element of the project, a key to the design of the building, which not only gives a spatial order, but responsible for maintaining all the facilities throughout the building. The columns are in fact hollow, and inside the facilities of moving light, telephone and stormwater devices are induced. That's all for now. Thank you.